Hi students, today we are discussing about the another phenomenon of fluids, that is surface tension. So before going toward the surface tension, let us discuss about some basic terms related to the surface tension. So first term, it is very important, that term is intermolecular force of attraction. What do you mean by intermolecular force of attraction? So for that purpose, consider here two molecules, first molecule and second molecule. So they are separated by a distance, that distance is supposed to be small r. Now when first molecule attracts second molecule, at the same time second molecule also attracts first molecule. In short, we can say that whatever may be the force between these two molecules, that force is intermolecular force. So this intermolecular force is always and always attractive in nature, so that's why we are called intermolecular force of attraction. So here two molecules are here, suppose molecule M1 and molecule M2. So in between any two molecules, whatever may be the force between them, that force is called as intermolecular force of attraction. Suppose one example we discuss here. Suppose we consider water molecules. So first molecules also of water and second molecules is also of water. They are separated at a distance of small r. Then their tendency is they are attracted towards each other, and whatever may be the attraction is called as attraction between two molecules is called as intermolecular force of attraction. Instead of two water molecules, we consider one molecule is of water, that is supposed to be water molecule, and another molecule is alcohol molecule. So whatever may be the molecules, the force of attraction between them is definitely intermolecular force of attraction. So in short, we can write the definition of intermolecular force of attraction. That is the force of attraction. The force of attraction between any two molecules. Between any two molecules. Between any two molecules is called intermolecular force of attraction. Stop.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Start group.
So we have seen meaning of intermolecular force of attraction. Now let us discuss about its type. So there are two types of intermolecular force of attraction. First force is called as cohesive force, and another force is called as adhesive force. Now we have seen the intermolecular force of attraction. Now let us discuss about its type. So what are the types of intermolecular force of attraction? See, mainly two types are there. First one is cohesive force and another is adhesive force. So these two forces are the intermolecular force of attraction. But what is the meaning of cohesive force? Then what is the meaning of adhesive force? So for that purpose, let us take one example of cohesive force. So firstly, we are discussing about the cohesive force. So see here, cohesive force means what? See here, for cohesive force, if we consider a substance, that substance is supposed to be water. This substance is supposed to be water. So, obviously, these two molecules are of water. So, whatever may be the force of attraction in between these two molecules of water, that force of attraction is called as cohesive force. Suppose, second example is kerosene. If two molecules, they are kerosene molecules, then the force of attraction between these two molecules, kerosene molecules, is definitely cohesive force. No doubt, these forces are also intermolecular force of attraction. But the intermolecular force of attraction means what we have seen, that is the force of attraction in between any two molecules. So here, listen carefully, two molecules are here, but these two molecules are from the same substance. It means that these two molecules are water molecules. So that's why whatever may be the intermolecular force of attraction, these intermolecular force of attraction is definitely cohesive. Why? Because these two molecules are from water, or we can say these molecules are from water molecules. Or in second example, these two molecules are kerosene molecules. That's why whatever may be the force of intermolecular force of attraction, that intermolecular force of attraction is cohesive. Means two molecules are there, they are from the same substance. So we can define the cohesive force like that. The intermolecular force of attraction between two molecules of same substance. So this word is very important. Same substance or from same object. So you should write here same substance. Same substance means both the molecules definitely from the same substance. So therefore, whatever may be the intermolecular force of attraction, that is cohesive force. The simple way to understand the cohesive force, let us consider we have taken water in a glass. Now, in this water, there are water molecules. So whatever may be the force of attraction between these water molecules, that force of attraction is definitely which type of force? Cohesive force. Okay. Now let us talk about the adhesive force, second type of intermolecular force of attraction. The adhesive force is also a force of attraction. So we consider here one example. Suppose two molecules, one molecule is from water and second molecule is from kerosene. So here first molecule, definitely it is from water, and second molecule, it is kerosene molecule. Now see, water molecule and kerosene molecule, they are quietly different. So in between these two molecules, definitely there is force of intermolecular force of attraction, but the type of intermolecular force of attraction is adhesive force. Why? Because here two substances are from water and kerosene. So this one is the first example. For second example, if we consider a water molecule and alcohol molecule. So in between these two molecules, also a force of intermolecular force of attraction, because these molecules are from different substances. So from this discussion, we can write the adhesive force. Now see the definition of adhesive force. The intermolecular force, no doubt it is intermolecular force of attraction. So that's why we are writing here the intermolecular force of attraction between two molecules. Between two molecules of different substance. So this is the most important word, different substance. So this different substance indicates that the molecule of first substance and the molecule of second substance, two molecule of substance, but the substance must be different. See here, already we have taken water into the glass. Now see here, two objects are here, two substance are here, one is a glass and another is water. Now we have seen, if we say that two water molecules, then definitely which type of force is there? Cohesive force. But if we consider the force between water molecule and the glass molecule, then definitely we can say that there is adhesive force. So how we can compare with adhesive and cohesive force? While we are talking about the cohesive force, then the intermolecular force of attraction between two molecules, but the two molecules must be from same substance. If we say adhesive force, so for that purpose, the intermolecular force of attraction between any two molecules, that two molecules must be from the different substance. So for purpose, water molecule and glass molecule, the force is adhesive force. So the force between two glass molecules, that is cohesive force, or the force between two water molecules, that is cohesive force. Stop. So see here, if we draw a line, so can you tell me, so which force we can apply here to draw the line, or if you write anything on this whiteboard? So I write here adhesive force, then its example, these definitions, by which force using we can write all these things. So definitely you can say, sir, this is whiteboard, so whiteboard molecules, and I am using marker, so in that marker there is ink. So another molecule is ink molecule. So definitely whiteboard molecule and ink molecule, so definitely they are from different substance. So if substance is different, then definitely which force is there? Adhesive force. So that's why when you are writing on whiteboard, then definitely you use which type of force? Adhesive force. Let us see the molecular range of intermolecular force of attraction. See here, two molecules which we are considering here. So first molecule and second molecule. These two molecules, they are separated at a distance of small r. Now see here, whatever may be the molecules, means the intermolecular force may be adhesive or cohesive, it doesn't matter. So but there is force of attraction between these two molecules. It may be cohesive or it may be adhesive. So molecular range means what? See here, if we consider first molecule is fixed and second molecule is far away from the first molecule. So suppose the distance between them we have to increase here. So we have to increase this distance up to which the intermolecular force is effective. If we fix first molecule and increase the distance by moving this molecule away from the first molecule, then the force of attraction becomes minimum. But if a distance is particular, or we can say whatever may be the distance up to which the intermolecular force is effective, that distance is represented by molecular range. Now see how we can define the molecular range. See, molecular range is nothing but just it is a distance. So we can write here the maximum distance between two molecules. The maximum distance between two molecules. One condition is there, which is up to intermolecular force is effective. So this is the most important condition for molecular range, is called molecular range. See, molecular range of intermolecular force of attraction means what? Just it is a distance, that is the maximum distance between any two molecules, but the condition is up to which intermolecular force is effective. Here you can put the word which. So up to which intermolecular force is effective, that is called as molecular range. So molecular range means what? Just it is a distance between two molecules, but the intermolecular force is effective. So let us try to understand sphere of influence. So sphere of influence means what? See, while you are considering any molecules, so you cannot just put one point so and say it's a molecule. So there is a particular method to represent a molecule. So you should put one dot, and around that dot we have to draw one circle or one sphere. So this is the proper way to indicate molecule. So this circular path, or we can say this sphere, is called as what? What is the meaning of this sphere? Let us see sphere of influence. So two molecules are here for that purpose. Suppose first molecule is this one and second molecule, which is at a distance of capital R. So capital R means what? Definitely it is a molecular range. Now you have to fix this first molecule. So this first molecule is fixed. It means the first molecule considered as a center, and whatever may be the maximum distance, that maximum distance is supposed to be molecular range. You have to consider that molecular range as a radius and draw one imaginary sphere around the first molecule, which is considered as a center. So whatever will be this imaginary sphere, that imaginary sphere is called as sphere of influence. So to draw the sphere of influence, two things are very important. Which are they? First one is, you should consider center of the first molecule, and your radius must be equal to the molecular range. So how we can define sphere of influence? Sphere of influence means what? Just it is an imaginary sphere. It is an imaginary sphere considering molecule at center and molecular range as its radius is called sphere of influence. Is called sphere of influence.